Operational report. Submarines detected. Oh, we lost a PT boat, damn it. Sinks at sea. Repairs complete. Repairs impossible. Repairs complete. Detection. Detection. Kill credit. Detection. Recon over Fusan. Detection. Kill credit. Crash. Crash. Damaged. Thunderbolt crashes. Shot down. Ooh. Even worser. Kill credit. Spotting report. Kill credit. Recon. Fusan. Detection. Crash. Base forces moved. Repairs complete. Expansions. Hey! Truck actually has enough supplies to expand. That's... See? There you go. You just never knew. How... Truck doesn't have any supply. Either it started from the beginning with supply or somehow it's getting supply. Fukuyama expands. The last... I think this is the last fragment has upgraded at Fukuyama. We'll check it. The damaged ship is ready at Pagan. Repairs complete. Reinforcement arrives Singapore. So a few things to check. One, the upgrade. So it looks like truck, even though there's no way to get supply to it, has supply and expands. So one of those surprising things. Let's take a look at the... Oh, sorry. First thing would be collision check. No collisions. Fukuyama. Let's see the last one. Here. It's upgraded. Good. Let's go to combat. Yahoo! Everybody can recombine. You know what this means? That means all the divisions have upgraded. Finally. So we're gonna go to the call up all the army units, all the U.S. Army units, all the infantry and armor. You can now start taking replacements. Turn on the replacements. But also, there's going to be artillery. Oops. Artillery take on replacements as well. Now the base forces, oh God, I want to take replacements, but jeez, they're all over the damn place. See, I don't really need replacements out here. If they don't get replacements, it's no big deal. Because they're not taking any losses, but all the bases on the island, yeah, we're going to have to turn on, oh God. Yeah, I know, go to each base, turn it on, go to each base, turn it on, one at a miserable time. Okay, all the bases on the front lines have been turned on. I could probably turn on a few more here, but really, what's the... Yeah, they're not taking losses. It's not a real big deal. I'm going to turn them on. I'm going to turn them on just because as we transfer them over to the island, sometimes the planes crash and they kill off a squad here or there, and we need to take replacements. But other than that, okay, let's go into... Oops. Now that we've turned them all on, pretty much all of them, all those on, let's go to the industry column, and we'll take a look at which ones have been stockpiled. We've been stockpiling the Observer Corps and these guys, the Churchills, we've been stockpiling as well. I don't even remember what we were stockpiling them to keep them so that we could upgrade some of the tank units. Let's see. Armor. And we wanted the British ones. Some of these. The Churchill, see? We want to go to Centurions, really? Do we even have... It's constant. Oh, man. Okay, well, gee. Do we have any Centurions? Now you have to go search through all this crap. We have 8 Centurions and we have Churchills here. So we've been holding them back, and I haven't been upgrading the, just because I don't see the need. We have Churchills, we are using Churchills, we have Shermans. See, we have these tanks, and these, even the light tanks, we may not use them, but if we got them, it's better to have some tank rather than no tank. Now this Centurion here, I could upgrade it, you know. But then we're going to be wanting all these other Centurions. Okay. Sure, let's upgrade this one. But we also kept them back so that we could see some of these are trying to upgrade to Churchills. But I don't want to. I've got hundreds of Shermans left over. So rather than fighting over the limited number of Churchills, I'd rather they take losses and then replace with Shermans. So that's why I've been stockpiling those Churchills. Now these guys, no, where's that small one here? The amphibious. These guys, I'm hoping to. I'm looking for 62 of them. Wow, I guess we don't have enough of them yet. Yeah, click through the whole thing, resort the whole thing again, because hey, the AI isn't, the game isn't smart enough to just use whatever you had last time. No, resort every single time. Well, we've got 59 amphibious tanks, but that ain't 59 isn't 62, so they're only getting 4 per month. Can you freaking believe that? 4 per month. So if we take no losses, we'll be ready to upgrade next month. Oh, for God's sakes. How ridiculous, huh? Who runs a war like that? So I'm going to upgrade 2 of these armored regiments because we've got 8 Centurions. So hopefully 4 will go here and 4 will go here. That way we mix them up with Centurions and Churchills. Some will use up as the Centurions arrive. These guys will use some Centurions and some Churchills, and the other ones, the Churchills, are there as a group, reinforcement, a pool of replacements as we take losses. It does seem as though the Centurions are quite popular tanks, and look at these guys. They're trying to upgrade to Centurions, right? So they would need 104 of the damn things. And this one here, oops, this one also, look, all that, 156, all Centurions. We don't have that many. But we do have a couple of hundred Shermans, so that's why we're going to keep using the Shermans while we wait for the Centurions, while the stockpile of Centurions builds up. But there just aren't ever going to be enough of those things. If I remember correctly, the Indians also use a lot of Churchills in their infantry divisions. So we're going to be there. That 100 is going to go fairly quickly when we start taking on, when we start hitting the heavier bases, taking heavier losses on Kobe, Osaka, and Nagoya. Submarine check. Look for damaged submarines. Okay, looks like their Kraken is staying on station. That's fine. Checking on endurance. Looks like Moray is already returning. Barbetto, let's set him for Nagasaki. Here we come. And Sea Leopard, already heading back for Nagasaki. At Naha, we have 3 submarines. We're going to send 1 to Chiba Station and 2 to Shikoku Station, and we're going to rebase them out of Nagasaki. No submarines ready at Iwo Jima. Manila, we're reloading, rearming, and repairing Hammerhead. Hammerhead's going to be in for a while. Okay, shipyard. She's badly damaged. Hold on. Does she need to be critical, or does it normal? Yeah, normal. Why take up extra dock space? It doesn't matter. Takes the same amount, same length of time. Stingray heading out for Chiba Station patrol. We're quiet on Singapore. Still trying to recover this one. That piece. What the hell is wrong with this aircraft? Reserve. Damage 6. One day. Repair the damn thing already. Convoy making their way out. We're quiet at Tarakan. At the Gaspi, we have. Oh, here's the squadron unloading. Okay. Unload and head back to Tarakan. This is a cruiser group heading out to reinforce Iwo Jima. At Manila, we have no ships have arrived. Apari still sending base forces up to Naha. One thing to be note, Manila, we actually dropped below. Look at that. Look at that. How the hell does that happen, really? I know. It's a screw up on my part. So I'm bringing some base forces, aviation base forces, back to Manila. We should have a cushion of a few hundred on here rather than be. We shouldn't be so tight with all this. So I've got a couple coming back just in case. This is our major base. We shouldn't. Where is that? Here? Well, whatever. I'm bringing the air wings back. There we are. So we should have a cushion of a few hundred. Quiet at Naha. No one. They weren't attacked. Okay. No attack. So we're going. Still sending them forward. The Mustangs have rested. Over to Kurume you go. Still sending base forces up to Kagoshima. On the front, we took a couple of bomb hits at Okayama, right? No problem, still building like crazy. Now that we've upgraded everything, all the infantry units, okay, we're here. We'll put everything into rest or combat. Well, we'll put the engineers in a combat mode so that they can build. Now, everything's still aimed for Hiroshima and Kobe and whatnot. Now, I got to get the... Yeah, everything's still aimed for all this other crap around here. That doesn't mean anything. Kobe armor is aimed for Kobe. And these guys are aimed for Hiroshima. Well, I don't want to cancel out the headquarters, so I got to move the headquarters out of here in order, because I can't sort the freaking thing. So I'll move it over to, let's say, well, we can move it anywhere, really. It doesn't really matter because the range of influence is 9. So we've got lots of, as long as we're within 9 of, I think 18 of Takamatsu, we exert command influence. So we'll get them out of here and then we'll set all the infantry to aim for Kobe. All right, all these guys are in, moved. Let's rebuild. Yeah, there's no point in distributing these guys because they're all under 3 here. How many do we need? We're looking for one extra one here. One extra one here. So there's no point in dispersing these guys. Okay, it looks like we're going to gather everyone. Yeah. We're going to rebuild, recombine all the dispersed units. Here we are getting reinforcements. The replacements come in a damaged form. Now that's 312. We only need one more. No point in dispersing this one either. Okay, recombining all the units. All units recombined. Notice the red. We're short on supplies for these guys. Well, I've wasted enough time already, so we're going to put these guys into movement mode. We're heading for Takamatsu. We'll put all the infantry, all the armor into movement mode, but none of the engineers. I think I'm going to leave the engineers. We don't need the combat engineers to break down Takamatsu. We should have enough weight of firepower. We're just going to leave them here. Always protect the engineers. Okay, so we're going to put everything in artillery and infantry into movement mode. The armor stays in rest Mode. Oh yeah, gotta stop. God, all this stuff you gotta do. Okay, so we're setting it move, heading from Takamatsu, set all to march. We've got to leave one garrison here. 20, that's fine. We can leave base forces here. This small one here, 115, I'll leave it for garrison on Takamatsu. We're not going to disperse these guys because we want them to arrive with full supplies. So next turn we'll add extra supplies. The supplies will flow to these units. Some of them we could disperse for a little while longer and try to recover, but I'm not going to do that. We've wasted enough time already. So armor is going to advance. Now the ones that are in rest mode, no, we can't be moving, or else I don't think they take replacements if they're moving. So I think, I'm not positive, but I think I have to stop these guys in order to get them to do their upgrades. But they're small units. Okay, that's the Aussies. The artillery is heading down south. I'm keeping two. Oh gosh. Let's see. We've got some of these anti-aircraft artillery regiments are staying in strategic move. We've got one of this Marine and the Canadians and the heavy artillery. So we've got a couple of them moving down. We're going to keep a couple of them here. We'll keep these two here. 610 and 607. 610 and 611 are going to stay here. The other two are going to move forward to Takamatsu. And the engineers, because we're not moving. Oh well, we are moving because we can't sort the stupid things. All right, so we'll throw them into strategic mode, and then drop them back into combat mode just to cancel the stupid orders. I am going to send one base force forward. Let's see which one, because when we arrive, I might want the option of having some aviation support there, but no, we don't have any. Okay, I'll send the Monab forward, but she's supposed to be garrisoned here. I'll pull another Monab over if I can. Where is it here? Where's the Monab? 9, right here. Okay, so we'll move this one over to fill in. Oh heck, I'll just move this one straight in. Oh heck, why do that, right? Just move it straight over here. Right down their throat. So this one, we don't have to. It's part of the 20. We only need 20 garrison here. So I was going to leave a couple of base forces to fulfill the garrison. The PT boats coming out of Hiroshima. Okay, we sank an enemy PT boat. Doesn't seem like there's anything else around here. They're heading back to Hiroshima. Now, I'm fairly confident there aren't any more torpedo boats around here. Not positive, but fairly confident there aren't any more at Matsuyama, that we can bring the submarines fairly safely into Hiroshima for repairs. The PT boats at Fukuoka, we're going to raid again at Fusan, but we pretty much destroyed everything on here. So now we're going to try to conduct a parachute assault over there. I think we're going to move the bombers over to Meisan. We'll start attacking Meisan. Okay, moved all the bombers over to attack Meisan. We got a 9-10 detection on it. Flying more recon on it. I'm also flying, fighter-wise, we have... I'm sending all the Thunderbolts, all the Thunderbolt 2s on it. A group of Thunderbolt Mustangs, Thunderbolts, regular Mustangs, and all the Thunderbolt 2s. That's a lot of fighters we're bringing over top. I don't know how tough the opposition is going to be. It says there are some fighters on here, but I just don't know how tough it is. So let's make sure the bombers get a good run. We're also flying some long-range combat air patrol over Fusan. We've got the 51 Deltas, one squadron flying over Mason, and one Corsair squadron flying over Fusan. And I'm bringing another Delta, the Mustangs, the Aussie Mustangs. Wow, 51 Deltas? Yeah. These guys are flying over Fusan. We're trying to conduct a parachute assault. Maybe we can capture the base and destroy these aircraft or drive them off. Oh, I think I said that the PT boats are also going to raid Fusan again. There, I don't know if the enemy has any ships here, if they fled, but I don't think we destroyed everything last time, so we're going to try again. Not only that, we're trying to pick up these last squads. I think we got them all. Well, we got a few of them last time. We're trying to pick up the rest from Ikishima. Tsushima is fine. We'll leave it for a little while longer. It has some supplies. They're not going to die. The fighter bombers. Last time we sent them for, it was this one. I think it was this one. This one, right. We sent them for Okishoto, and I don't know if it flew or not. I don't know. It's got a zero rating. I just don't know if it flew at Okishoto. So we're going to try it again. It took fatigue. It took fatigue of 14, so I don't know. Where did it get it? Did it just fly over the one hex here? The transports. We're still unable to drop anything at Okishoto, so we're trying again. I've got transports picking up Ikishima, dropping at Fusan, and trying to drop at Okishoto. No attack on Kanoya. The tankers are happily unloading. Ground troops are unpacking. Oh, there are they unpacked already? Yeah, they seem to have unpacked. Okay, so time to start marching them out of here. Over in the Bonins, here we have these guys moving southwest. Destroyers and transports moving. Okay. These are cruiser group. We've used up about a quarter of the ammo and some of the torpedoes. So we still have enough, I think, to kill. All right, let's set it moving southwest, huh? Let's move here and then here. We've also got the cruiser group here. You're moving to the southwest, eh? All right. Let's move here and then try to come up here. This group moving westward is patrol boats and minesweepers, supposedly. Probably a small group. Either way, once these guys engage, we'll send them home afterwards. I don't know how often these guys will engage, but it's the heavy cruiser group. And here's the Barker, damaged, returning. Either way, we're short. We're going to be running out of one group here. Let's grab a couple of destroyers. Do we have any more destroyers? Yeah, we can grab a couple of destroyers. It's a pretty good group here. Let's set the patrol zone out here now. Sure, let's move it up there. Checking on damaged ships. Setting them for repair. Dugan, Truan. Alright, let's finish her. Haddock is in some serious hurt here. Okay, let's get to critical. Let's get to pier side. Let's get them repaired and get them out of here. Well, Charles P. Cecil will not repair any further than this, so we may as well move him up to readiness and send him. Let's see, how badly is he damaged? Speed of 10, he can make it to Manila, no problem. Okay, you got to remember, here's a cruiser group, Gambia. You don't need the aircraft, so get out of here. We're going to transfer to Iwo Jima and just let it wait. Let them wait for the cruisers to arrive from Manila. Okay, here we have the transports. They're going full speed, running like a son of a gun, right? And tankers also Running. Oh, let's. Yeah, they should be okay. Running like a son of a gun. We have the ship in front. In front, we're going to set meet and which one? Who's lead? Who's lead? Ah, 7-8. Okay. And follow. These guys are in front. All right. Set meet. 7-8. And follow. Here come the carriers. Everyone, we're going to set meet 7-8 and follow. I still think that these transports back here can actually make it up. They're 3 hexes away. That's a half a day steaming, and they got to make it up before the up here. I think we can make it. Going running at full speed, burning out the engines. They can get up here and they can join, combined with these guys. Now, one of the things, we had some air attacks on Iwo Jima. That's never happened before, right? We've got the cruisers here. They fought and they defended and they were fine. But it's never, the AI has never, I don't think it's ever attacked Iwo Jima. And I wondered why the hell's going on, right? And they attacked the transport group south of Iwo Jima. This is the AI showing me how tough it is and how far it can reach. So took a look at what's happening at Iwo Jima, and I found that my Mustangs are sitting there sweeping and resting and looking at what the hell. I must have recombined them in order to get more fighters on here, to jam more fighters on here, and I must and forgot to set them back up on combat air patrol. Oh, we were using the drop tanks and going long range. That's right. And then after that, we brought them back to short range, and I forgot to put them back on combat air patrol. Well, that was stupid, wasn't it? Okay, so we've got, and also the Thunderbolts were short on aircraft. I forgot to add them last time, so I'm going to add them now. Yeah, I know it's the middle. I know it. I know. It's not the 8th of February. I know. I know. I normally do it the 1st, 8th, 15th, and 22nd. But these guys are important because they're flying long range, and if they got damaged, we need as many airplanes in this group as possible. Okay, so we've got 225. We're overstocked right now. We're going to break up the Mustangs, and I'm going to order one Mustang group to rest. Nope, we're still 200. We're 205. That means we're a little bit over on the stack, but that's fine. I'll rest one Mustang group at a time. So because the Mustangs weren't flying, I think that's why the AI got enough balls to attack us. I'm hoping so. I'm hoping so, because I'd hate to have to keep flying around here. I think by having air superiority over the base, the AI should not attack us again. I'm thinking about pulling the Corsair group out of here. We don't need them. We don't seem to need them over here. They haven't been getting many kills. They're getting experience, which is fine. I mean, they're getting good at it, but it's also overstacking the base. So I'm thinking about pulling these guys out. Let's try that. Let's rest these guys. And let's fly all Mustang. All Mustang all the time. Let's see. We're still 206. I know we're 206, but if we pull the Corsairs out of here, you'll be way under, okay? So stop nagging. Stop nagging me. Let's see if this works. I think the Corsairs were just insurance. We didn't really need them. I was worried, but my worries are unfounded. I thought that there was going to be a lot more air attack on Bonin Islands. Pagan, we're quiet. We're re repairing. We've. Oh yes, all these damaged ships, we're going to get them out of here, send them off to, oh, first unload them and send them off to, should I go Manila or, I think I'm going to send them, to Pearl Harbor. Why? Because it's on the way back. What's right out here? Let's go. Okay, we'll go cure. Why? Because it makes me force it, it forces me to go out in this direction. That's all. That's all. We'll organize them according to speed. The 10 speeds are going to go in one. The 11s and the 12s will go in another. Yeah, that's going in the general direction. We'll repair at Pearl Harbor, and then I'll send them off to pick up supplies at Panama. We're quiet at Pearl Harbor. Midway, a few more repaired, recovered. These are rested. We're sending them on to Kurume. The transports are leaving Midway, heading back to Hilo for more supplies. Okay, we have room on Midway now, so let's send a couple more. Whoa! We're working through our squadrons. Good job. Sending them down to Midway for transfer. Checking the ships in the wormhole. Seeing if we can go into full speed. Nope, we're still going to be a couple of days out. So probably another 2 days before we can. Here, same. Holy cow. We only have fuel for 49. And the range is 83, I think that's what it is. Yeah. So we have right now we have a range of 197 at this speed, but once we go to full, we only have a range of 49, and the distance is 83. I think that's the way it reads. I could be wrong. Los Angeles. Hey, we have a few more filled up. You know, one, there's four, five, six. Yeah, I think we're going to break them out, send them along. This was not quite full yet, but I'm going to, for 2%, 100 points, I'm not going to worry about it. They're the right speed, so they're off. These other, I'm holding back these. It's a 12 speed, so I'm holding it back until the other 12s are ready to go. Let's see, how many, let's add some more. Keep loading. San Francisco, no new reinforcements. Wait, no, the Clan MacDonald has repaired. Who else is still under repair? Clan MacDougall? Well, I think we'll wait for the Clan MacDougall to repair, and we'll send them at the same time. I'm going to go alert Clan MacDonald. We'll load it. And we got plenty of time to load fuel and other crap. So it's not a big deal. Oh, I forgot. There's a transport arrived at Singapore. Well, when's the next? Our next reinforcement arrives in 24 days. So I could load the darn thing. Ah, well, we'll just save it here. Maybe it'll load part of the division as part of the reinforcement. The tankers have arrived in Lihue. Let's refuel these guys. They're damaged. We'll try to repair the ones we can, what we can here. Not much, but we're in no rush for these things. So I'll start a couple of tankers, the undamaged ones. We may as well dock and start loading. The evacuation convoy, or the reinforcement convoy, approaches. I've taken all my all my dry transports, and we formed them up into 176 and 99. We're loading them up with supplies. So that's 600,000 on this one. There's 500,000 on that one. It's 1.1 million and another 250. So 1.35 million supplies. That's pure supply. We're going to take out of Manila. Here comes the retrieval convoy. So once we load them, we're going to come down here to Legazpi and then switch out the empty transports for full ones and take them back up to Kanoya. Blower launches two torpedoes and sinks the destroyer. Noyate. I think we sank it. One hit may not sink it, but close. The motor torpedo boats. Ah, see, lots of actions here. Lots of action here. Motor torpedo boats are hit by the, PT boats. Many are sunk. Night contact near Iwaki. The Marblehead and Tromp catch the destroyer. Okay, we hit. Nah, didn't get the destroyer though. Killed all the transport, but not the destroyer. Guardfish launches two torpedoes at a submarine. Miss. Shark holds fire against two subchasers. Sawfish also holds fire against those two subchasers. PT boats find the motor torpedo boats at Fusan, but do not engage at 2,000 yards. Cowards. Ah, crud. We lose another one from a mine strike. We lost one the other day, but... yeah, Fusan's gonna have that kind of a problem, isn't it? Tsurugi. Night raid on Shimonoseki. Three are damaged. PT boats withdrawing to Hiroshima. Looks like there's still too much activity around here to bring the submarines through safely. Guardfish evades an E-boat. The PT boats try again at Fusan. We sink one motor torpedo boat. Losing one torpedo boat, PT boat for a motor torpedo boat. Yeah, one for one. The Ho launches two torpedoes at a submarine. Miss. PT boat encounters submarine, midget submarine at Fukuoka. Can't do anything about it. Frobisher and Glasgow catch the last. Oh, no, not the last. Catch a coastal freighter and sink it. Yeah, should have stuck around the coast, not be sailing around in the middle of the ocean. I think the destroyers, the escort destroyers, escaped, unfortunately. I want to kill them more than I kill these little merchants. Air raid on the on Maison, 150 Division. Bring it. The enemy defends with 38 fighters. Oh, good. All the Thunderbolts. Now we can get some revenge, hopefully. Kill eight. Yeah, we got some revenge. For their poor performance over, I don't know what you call that area, near Matsui. Yosu Fortress under attack. No defender. Well, that's pretty good. Pretty good damage-wise. Pretty good. The 152nd Anti-Aircraft Regiment under attack. Not many hits. No, not a good result. Under attack again. That's modest. That's pretty good. 150 Division, miss. Total miss. 152nd Anti-Aircraft Regiment, miss. Total miss. Come on, 150 Division, bombed again. We're whittling them. Yeah, we're shaving them down one at a time. That could take a long time. Oh, here come. This must be a heavy raid with the four engine bombers. Taking a long time to calculate. So these guys are probably slower than the other ones. That's why the other ones went in very quickly. Look at that raid. Let's count one. Let's count one of these. Okay. So that's 100 here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 1,000 plane raid. This is over 1,000 plane raid. No losses, no destroyed, but they might crash on the way home. That's a respectable hit. Respectable. What did we hit? The 150 Division. Really knocking it about. 150 Division, hit again. Good hits. Got killing. A killing blow. 150 Division, hit again. Killing. That's right. Destroy them now. They're disabled. Destroy. 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 30 more destroyed. Minor. 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 Air attack on the task force at Kanoya. Uh-oh, maybe he's coming after those tankers now. Can't tell. Can't tell which ones he's bombing. The Nils and Jill's torpedo bombers. Six are shot down. Oh, it looks like he's going after the torpedo. They're the tankers. Eight Patsy's attack. Four shot down. Air raid on Okayama. Nick fighter bombers. We shoot down three with the anti-aircraft guns. Air raid on Hiroshima. How many is that? 23, 30, 40, 50, 60 or so 65 aircraft. We defend with over 100 and 100, 150? No, 200. 200 aircraft. We shoot down 16. Air raid on Kanoya. Did you see what are they attacking? I can't remember. 10 piggies, 4 shot down. Air raid, looks like it's the tankers they're going after. 12 Bettys, 5 shot down. I guess the AI just couldn't resist those big, fat, beautiful tankers sitting there. Shock attack. Fusan. 7-1 odds. Captured. Look at all those things. Oh, yeah. Take that, you scum. Destroyed. Fukuyama expands port to 3.